Okay. Greetings, salutations, and hello, interwebs. This is your friendly online feline neighbor, Timotabby, once again bringing you some video game goodness with yet another new game, when I should be completing other games that I have yet to complete, but this one's a bit more important for me. The sequel just came out, and I really wanted to play this one first before I touched it. I also need to finish Control before I can touch it, because technically there is DLC that does link Alan Wake to Control, and there might be references of Control in Alan Wake 2. There's also probably references to American Nightmare, but I don't know if I have any means of playing that game, so I know about the doppelganger. That much I know. But yeah, this was a game I've been wanting to come back to for a long time, especially when the remastered came out. Just did not get a chance to get around to it. And I know I'm a little late to it, considering the sequel just came out. But if you know my situation, things did not work out the way I was hoping it would. And I'm kind of lagging behind and very strapped for hours. So, in that particular regard, I'm going to do my best to just kind of focus on playing the game. I'll still be on the mic, but this will probably be one of the few quieter commentary games. Which is going to really suck, because I'm probably going to have to at least talk around the music. The music's cool. In fact, Remedy and Alan Wake, if not Max Payne 2... is how I got introduced to Poets of the Fall. But this game specifically, because of the band's extra involvement in producing original music for this particular story. But we'll get to that down the line. But yeah, unfortunately, I know that YouTube is most likely going to try to hit me with copyright strikes or restrictions because of blah blah blah, so I have no way of figuring out how to get around that, because I am not muting the music, because it would ruin the experience. And I might have to edit it if that becomes a major problem, trying to have this for anybody to view. So that's why it's going to be kind of a lack in, I'm probably not going to talk too much during the music portions, because I'll probably get flagged anyways. If I'm talking over it, it'll still pick it up. So if it does become a problem, I'll probably just have to edit that out and just get to the bits where I do start talking. Anyways, though, I have not actually played this game. I watched a friend of mine complete the game. I watched it alongside him throughout, as if I was watching a show or a movie, which is fitting considering that Alan Wake plays in episodes, and that's where most of the music ends up coming up at the end of the games, or at the end of the episodes, though there's some sprinkled around, I think. But I love the setup of it. I love that it was an episodic type of game, and this is regarding an author, a horror suspense writer in a horror setting. This is up my alley. This is just up my alley. I love the literations in here. I love the little sprinkles of using the writer's influence in directing this game, or being directed by the character itself. I don't know, I'm not explaining it well, and this is also early in the morning. I just had my coffee, and I'm trying to get this out of the way, because I'm not going to be available later this evening, I don't think. So I'm just trying to get as much of this done now, and I'll try to do this again tomorrow morning. Probably even earlier, but we'll see. But yeah, with that said, let us revisit Bright Falls in its heyday. It's the first time I think we were revisiting the lighthouse. Hello there, welcome to the stream. I am a Jess about to start the show. Actually, wait. Options. Later. It's fine. Put on the subtitles. Well, that doesn't help me in seeing how large it's gonna be. Video commentary? What? There's commentary in this? Yeah, whatever. Statistics, playback, credits. Okay. Alright, now we begin. And I ain't going to nightmare. I'm going to normal.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there. I'd seen the hitchhiker too late. He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again. Suddenly, his body was gone.
Episode 1. Nightmare.
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
No. There's a wall here. Alan Wake, Alan Wake. Now, I'm trying to remember
I
if
had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
I know. I'm trying to remember if Night Springs was also something featured in Max Payne as one of like the television ads or something. Cuz I do remember some trippy television moments. Something with a flamingo, maybe. In the Max Payne series, but I don't remember much more after that. Ranko Point. Okay, I'm seeing the little map thing on my side. Yes, I know. But I am a cat. I wish to explore.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
Oh, no. Oh, this cat gonna be doing a lot of scavenging. Maybe they'll be in, like, really easy to notice spots or something. And I won't be that much of a trouble. I wonder what the thermoses would do. The sudden stop. Oh, hi, guy.
You don't even recognize me, do you, Ryder?
You think you're God? You think you could just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think
you're okay.
You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer. You're a joke. There would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You will never publish another one.
I'm
gonna kill you. It's not like your story's already good. Not like they haven't
yet. Artistic merit.
You're a lousy writer. Cheap thrills
and pretentious shit.
That's all you're good for. Just look at me.
Look at your work.
Okay. Thought that would have had something back there, but I guess not. Oh, I can jump. Okay. No, we're gonna do that later. I'm not gonna take a picture of that right now. I can.
You can't stop me.
Oh, okay. I gotta hold it down.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
Die by the hands of your own creation.
Oh, you're not really happy. Maybe you are.
Trapped. There was no way out.
I don't know what you want me to do, game.
Follow the light.
Hold on.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there. Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. This way, there's no time.
There is always time, Bajello.
You must follow me now. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light. Turn your flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Now you'll die.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
Who's seen the light without two blinds the enemies and burns the darkness away faster? Okay. Not today, Satan! Or disgruntled worker? Or character? Whatever the hell you are.
This is it.
Back away! Ah, okay, good to know. I see a thermos. That is now 2 of 100, I believe. Quadruple! No, I'm sorry, triplets. Triplets. I don't know why it said quadruple. Oh. Oh! Oh! Ho! Ho! I took a chance. Oh, God damn you. Oh, fuck. I felt something coming my way. Woo-hoo. Okay, now I am doing it. Oh, God. I have no. Ah, what? Okay, come on. Give me a breather. No, fuck off.
I can keep this up.
Yeah, I got the sense of that. Okay. He has stamina. I can't run forever. Thermos! Pick you up. Into the light!
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Welcome to Bright Falls.
We're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
One moment.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Damn yuppies.
Okay. Just checking for thermoses.
Time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us.
I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to beat this. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. So you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word, and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
He is just a Barry. Barry is Barry.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord, a Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave. I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose, I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Move it along.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Bright Falls, the home of the annual Deer Fest.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
Which I feel like is part of the theme of the sequel.
Or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
Yes, I have a wife. Leave me alone.
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
Weird lighting, but yes, sir.
You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder you in your sleep.
It does that. Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Yes, that's my favorite tune. Coconut.
Shut your mouth, you demented.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
Shut it. This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Are you Thor? Do you two happen to have a cousin that works as a janitor at a specific governmental building by any chance? I would be concerned if they would let people through there. Thermos. Coffee World! While in Watery Ama. Let's see. Anything else to look at before I need to move the plot? Just noticing some fancy portraits.
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
You have no idea, sir. You have no idea. Oh, okay. You're making me go around. He really does seem to like that song. Hi, Log Lady. I'm sorry, Light Lady. Okay.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Well, that was the warmest bathroom anyways.
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
If I had that light switch right now, none of this would be happening.
I'm so happy this could be arranged.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
No, I didn't get lucky at all.
And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
I hadn't seen her leave, but the old lady was gone.
Woo woo! And he fell asleep.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you alright?
Splendid, splendid! Damn hernia! It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
The Andersons, they're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Interesting. Bye, Mr. Wake. Bye-bye.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Uh-oh.
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on KBF FM.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
Divers Isle.
It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Well, that's gonna be a problem because I'm searching. And I'm stuck. Boy, this was a long trek down, wasn't it? Ha 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 ha!
The cabin obviously got its name from the shape of the island. It looked like a giant bird leg. Alice had mentioned that the lake was a caldera. There was a dormant volcano under it.
Oh, caldera? I thought this was called Cauldron Lake. Okay, I got my thermos. Do 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 do, won't let me run. Do 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 do. Just enjoying the hiking trail. Can. What does that say? Bird Lake Cabin. Wish there was a way to switch the shoulder perspective. Oh, there is. Oh, okay. Well, there we go. God, I love the music of this game. This was back in 2010, folks. Gotta remember that. This was back in 2010.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Oh, I guess I was supposed to be here anyways.
Alice had told me about Cauldron Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel.
Whoa, wait, hey! I wasn't
it was
done!
A place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here. These days, it was no longer open to the public.
Oh, wait, it is called Cauldron Lake. I'm confused.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
A particular love story, maybe. Nice. Oh, right. Jump over it? No. Okay. Won't let me break the game that way.
Alice? Honey?
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Kept from sleep, in her dreams to prevail, the labyrinth of me, the temple of shadow and mist.
The old door had played a trick on me. Alice wouldn't have come out in the dark.
Guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. A famous artist, no less, but we'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Let's go to the phones, caller. You're on KBFFM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it? He's my favorite writer.
Well, Rose, I
just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat Main on KBFFM, and now some music.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
Hey, at least the DJ man, there's a different name for it. He was gonna keep your secret, but Rose had to blurt it out.
The water was black. I couldn't help but imagine all sorts of horrors lurking in the depths below.
Oh, so many horrors, sir. So many horrors. Ah, thermos. Yes.
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Not that one.
Surprise!
Oh, never mind.
What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
hey,
keeps...
Hey, 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 just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe... So now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like that. That's not... Alan? Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. God damn it.
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
You got some deep-seated issues if you're going to be screaming at your wife for trying to help you. And it doesn't seem like you meant it, but...
Damn it. Alice?
Alice?
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
Alan! Alan! Where are you? Help!
Alice, I'm coming! It's all right! I'm coming!
No!
What the hell?
Alan! Help me! Alan! No! No! Ah!
Alice? Ah! Alice? Oh, no!
Okay, that's points on his heroism. He is willing to dive into the murky waters for his wife.
Wake up.
Alice?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
Yes, how did you get from diving into the water to suddenly... crashed here. Can I?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
And apparently I won't like him in Control either. Spoilers, I guess, I just said out loud, sorry.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Fucking herbs.
Damn.
Bye-bye, car. Where we're going, we don't need vehicles. Probably best not to chance dropping off there. No, I don't trust you. Oh, I don't have my flashlight? Oh, wait, right, yeah.
Hello? Is someone there?
Now these collectibles become activated.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh, joy.
Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Find the page in nightmare difficulty mode? You're gonna make me play? Alright, fine. Okay, I guess I'll have to figure that out another time. Alright, then actually, I'm not gonna look headstrong for these things. I'll look up a guide later, because I'm not gonna be that crazy, yet here I am going off the beaten path, doing exactly what I said I was gonna say I was gonna ignore. Because I am a cat, I am curious.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident!
Yeah, no, you don't want these people, Alan.
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Never mind. Okay, they're not that crazy. So I have to do it with this tree.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Oh, no, no! Okay, good.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Whoopsies.
Hey. Hey, you.
Phil.
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Nightfall.
Oh, hell.
Carl... Ducky,
please,
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square. Fair and square.
So I have no flashlight. I have no gun. How am I supposed to defend myself? Whoops. Premium cabins, huh? Well, your cabin sucked. Then again, wait, what?
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Ho! Oh, shit! Oh, wow, I actually used it correctly. Nope, fuck you.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Yay, I have my defenses. But only two batteries. Yeah, I'm aware of that. Oh, good. More batteries. Oh, excellent. More batteries. I only have 12 shots, though. Wonderful.
During your...
Okay, that's good.
Your recommend trying Nordic walking. It's the latest thing. Incontestably proven health benefits let you but one stone. You can see the sights and keep those cholesterol levels down at the same time.
Good to know.
Yes.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station. How may I...
Hello?
Okay. Well, so much for that.
The spirit.
Get out. Ow. What hit me? Office went bye-bye.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Thank you. Oh, no. Tappa.
Concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone, or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Ooh, actually. Nope, never mind. It's on forever now. Oh, it's trying to tell me things. And obviously I can't jump that. Was I hearing an enemy or a pig? Oh, I was hearing the electrical sparks. I don't think that did anything. can turn back on. Alright. Yes, yes, yes. I see your arrow. Wait, did it? No, never mind.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
I'll take that, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Good for crowd control. Oh, okay, now I can cross this, because the power's off.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
What, can you? I haven't tried that. Don't! Yeah, you can't. Woo! Experiencing an average day in Maine. Maine does not have average days these days. I won't get into the real life shit going on, but yeah, God. In regards to this, hello there, Hex. Oh, batteries, revolvers. Is that it? That was it. Good. I want me to go that way, but I want to go this way. Cat gonna explore! No matter how many times I said I wasn't. Ooh, wow. All the way down here.
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now, she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
Wait. Sorry, hold on. I somehow misread something. Rose knew she'd be good. Rose knew she'd be gushing, but right now she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty confident, at ease with Wake, not like Rose. They were perfect. Okay. Rose was jealous, is what was going on. I'm guessing as long as I don't touch that, I'm fine. Doo-doo-doo. Whoa! That was sudden.
What the hell was that?
Evil things. Evil things.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Ha-ha-ha! Thermos! Do not fall in the water, do not fall in the water. so I have to go this way. Do I see goodies? I see oh, it's a manuscript.
Barry Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon, but Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that, not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Well, that is a sign of a good friend who actually knows about their peeps and want to take care of them. Okay, so, am I going the wrong way? No.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Take that. Lithium batteries. I think those are like the better batteries, I think. Or they'll last longer when I'm, trying to blind someone. Hi, sir. I tried to do the thing. Nope, wrong person. Back off. Damn it. All right. Where are you? There you are. Caution. Proceed at your own risk. I have to look.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way. I couldn't stay here. There had to be a way to get up there.
The stairs were useless.
I had to find something else to help me climb up there.
I thought I saw something flashing in the dark. Come on. Yoink, yoink, yoink. Limit reached. Okay. Aha! I can't pick up any more batteries either. Cool. Nope, can't climb that. Okay, so I'm loading on gun, I'm loading on flare, I think, and I'm loading on potatoes. I'm sorry, batteries. Batteries are the potatoes of life. So says I, the sleepy cat. Meow. So I'm assuming I need to figure out how to move certain platforms. Guess that I'm going all the way back here.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
Hi! Okay, actually, you know what? Run. I want these guys out in the open. Isn't this the dodge? Why couldn't I dodge those axes? Maybe I'm...
With all this forestry equipment around, there had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Also, I didn't fully explore. Ha ha! Thermos, thank you. Can't climb it. There was a ladder here, if I remember. Yes. This might just be a safe haven area. Or, I think I might know. Manuscript. Weird container.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
There we go. Easy way to get out of that. Yes! Now give me more shots! Activates that. As much as I want to play with a shotgun, I want to get ammo for it first. Like, more ammo. Hi, you shadowy dill whackers. Show yourself, I know you want to ambush me. You want to ambush me? Really? Okay, well, first thing I want to do. Oh, I guess I did pick it up already. Got it. There we go. Oh. Wait, yeah, there it is. I actually was almost afraid that was gonna break. Nothing of value here. Ooh. I know you want me in there, but I'm not going in there yet. Man, look how far I've already traveled. Aha!
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Okay, maybe I better go back in there. Mine. Okay, 4 rounds. Cool.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. As you listeners know, I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks,
Pat. You have a good night now.
We're gonna unfortunately kill that dog, aren't we? I better go now. That's another copyright music. Oh, hold on. I forgot the name and the meaning of the person, but yes. Oh, good. Lots of flare gun ammo. Okay, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go, I gotta go. Wait. It must be telling me the same area. Okay.
The gas station was closer now, its light welcoming in the darkness.
Dude, you're making me hungry. Stop. Oh, hi! I tried to do the thing! Okay. Bunk and bunk. Damn it. Bunk. I know I could recharge my battery, but I wanna be a fucking professional. Oh, I saw you out there. I saw you out there. Wait. Safe haven. I see. Oh, God. Okay. Okay. I'm having fun with my shotgun today. Fuck off. Where's the other guy? Okay. I see. I have to be careful. I gotta start coming out of the woodwork the longer I'm out here. Hi, sir. Fuck you. You know what? There we go. Oh, that apparently didn't work. Okay, switch. And you screwed. Okay.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
There is no spoon, there is no spoon, there is no spoon, there is no spoon, there is no spoon.
Thank you.
Wait, was I supposed to come this way? Oh, I'm going the right way. I thought I was going the wrong way. No, fuck off. Okay, I thought I was supposed to go down this way. I'm just making certain I'm not missing anything. Alright, try this again. I forgot where I was going. Okay. Hopefully I didn't miss anything else. I guess I'd have to look for it later. Yeah, I forgot how the system works when you're... Can I just replay the episode with everything I've acquired? Or do I have to recapture everything again? This looks final. I kind of didn't quite catch all that. Reload, or I forget. Yeah, fuck you. That's what I say to that ambush.
For such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs. Tonight's episode, A Quantum Suicide.
Strap yourselves in, everyone.
If lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you can see, this is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet, I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality!
Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Felled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. In Night Springs.
Meow! Shut up! Stop reminding me. Okay, wow. Just, like, wow. This is why you be careful when you play with science, kids. Don't get too big of a head about it. Yeah, so that gate's opening. Yay. Okay, so I'm only missing one more page before it's the ones I have to find in nightmare mode.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying, or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Okay, so I'm only missing one more manuscript. And here they come again to ruin my Saturday. Save it for the big boys. Something about a spark plug I heard. Sorry, the deafening whoosh of this darkness fog cloud wind blowing in is kind of deafening my ears. We're doing this? Oh God! Hey, come on, move, man, move! Move! Ah!
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights of the gas station alive.
Is that reloaded? Okay. I have a lot of ammo. I think I could try nightmare mode next time then. The way I'm playing. Then again, maybe they'd be more scarce, or they won't give me the same... I knew it! Thermos! They won't give me the same amount of ammo. Or maybe it just means higher damage, I don't know. Checking around town. Maybe there is. I almost fell off to my death.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
For a moment. Oh, there's my last thing.
Stucky spat on the garage floor and tried to shake the cobwebs from his head. Ever since the couple never showed to pick up the keys, things had been fuzzy. Something, a feeling, caught his attention. Stucky looked up and stared as his brain tried in vain to process the horror before him. He stumbled back, knocking over a can of oil. A black pool spread across the floor while he struggled for a brief moment, then let go as the unrelenting darkness engulfed him.
Sixty-eighth annual Deer Fest in 7 days.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now. I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Okay, I doubt there'd be any thermoses out here. In fact, it's probably gonna somehow. Or there is! Oh! Except this is the danger for doing what I'm doing. Okay, I gotta hurry. Oh, reload. Pick up! Run! I'm trying! It won't let me run much more! I saw you! Get back to the light! Get back to the light! Okay. The dangers of exploration and of looking for things. I doubt they'll. Well, actually, you are making me wonder now. If that was possible, then so many other things could have been possible. Hi! Eat that! Oh God, someone's still alive. Huh. A brief sanctuary? Not one that will last. Okay, this was Bumpkiss. This was great, eh, Bumpkiss? No, I'm just oh god. I'm a pick. I'm running. I paint. Come on. I'm so close. No. I can get away. Oh no, I didn't save any of that. Okay, well now I know better. Manuscript stuck red. Spat in the garage. Yeah, heard it.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Okay, I
had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Okay, there was only this one, and then there was only one over here. Ah, no, you don't. It just occurred to me, they're kind of exploding like they're pages. Back off! I'll make you fun size! Ow! Oh, fuck you. And you walk right back into the darkness like the little fucking dark bitch you are. Okay, alright, yeah, I know better.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Alright, I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
How much of your mind is already gone just writing this story? Not yet. Okay. The 68th Annual Deer Fest, September 15th to the 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contests, and surprise competitions, live music for the children, Bucktooth Charlie afternoons, and Montgomery the Mystic's Amazing Phantasmagoria evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deer Fest parade. Deer Fest is gonna have a whole. Gonna have a whole new meaning in the sequel. Okay. Phone time.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
Thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station. Okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
candy-colored clown they call the Sandman. Tiptoes to my room every night, and just to sprinkle stardust and to whisper, go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away into the magic night. I softly say a silent prayer.
I can imagine credits rolling in this way.
Previously on Alan Wake. I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it! God damn it, Alice!
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Okay, I'm gonna hope I can replay the previously when I come back, because this is where I'm gonna have to stop for now. So, yeah, for most of you who probably watching the pre-recorded, I'm probably gonna have to cut out that entire song segment, because otherwise, I'm probably going to get copyright dinged, and there's a possibility that could make it hard for other people around the world to watch this pre-record, which sucks, but, yeah. Which also is going to suck, because I am definitely listening to all the music, especially when it gets to a particular band of mine. And it's also going to be kind of interesting how it's going to work with a segment later on, because that particular band's going to have an original song for this game that has to play out twice, because it is story related, or at least one is kind of a fight related thing, one is an actual related to the story of this game. So we'll see how that happens. But yeah, I'm gonna need to take a break for a little bit. I need to actually do some freshening up. I might come back with episode 2 soon or later today, but otherwise it's probably going to be tomorrow morning. But keep an eye on my Twitter or Blue Sky if you want to get any updates about if I'm about to stream soon or not. But until then, everybody, for those of you who are watching the stream, lurking in the background, or just watching the pre-records, thank you for tuning in. I hope I was able to keep things entertaining for you. And I'll catch you all next time. And I also wish you a wonderful rest of your morning, day, afternoon, evening, night, whenever it is in your neck of the woods. Take care.